here's an algorithms video for you. Let's say you have an array from which you need to repeatedly extract sublists and sum them up. These sublists can be of any size, and you're expected to perform this summation many times using different sublists. This is a fairly common thing to do if, let's say, you're doing averages across a set of data. But if you don't do it right, your code is going to do a whole bunch of extra work. More on this after the break. Hello and welcome back to another video. A naive solution to our sum of sublists problem would be to simply loop. For each request, start at the beginning index of the sublist and loop your way through to the end index, maintaining the sum as you loop on through. This works, but it's unfortunately not quite efficient. If your array has n items, then for each request, you have to look up to n items. If there are m requests, you have to do this m times. Since you're doing n steps, m times, under the big O notation, that comes up to O m times n, quadratic time. This Python code has 10,000 items and 10,000 requests, and even on a fast CPU, it takes over a second to run. Here's how you can make things a little more efficient. We're going to build an intermediate data structure that is essentially a list of cumulative sums. Create a new array the same size as your inputs, copy the first item, then for each subsequent item, sum the value from the input array at the index with the value in the cumulative array at the previous index. This works because for each index in the cumulative sums array, each element is the sum of the items up to that point. If I wanted to figure out the sum at the next index, I can simply have the cumulative sum I have so far and then add the next value to it. That way, I'm able to build this array with just one pass through the input. The last item in the array should be the sum of all numbers in the input. Now, the question is, why create this array? How does it help us? The idea is simple. Let's say we want to sum up this sublist of items, which starts from the very first item in the original array and stops somewhere in between. No problem, right? If we look at our array of cumulative sums, the answer is sitting right there. We got to it with just one lookup operation. But we got lucky here. What if we want a sublist that does not start from the beginning? You wouldn't find this answer anywhere inside the cumulative sums array. Thankfully, this isn't too hard either. If you look in the box corresponding to the n index in the cumulative sum array, this number represents a sum of all numbers from the beginning. This is a good start, but it extends into these elements that we don't want. Is there a way in which we can quickly exclude these values? Why, yes. The values we don't want always start all the way from the left. Therefore, to get at their sum so we can exclude them, we simply need to look into the cumulative sums array, one position before the start point of our sublist. So, to find the sum of any sublist, you simply need two lookup operations on the cumulative sum list. The first sum covers everything from the start up to the end point. From that number, subtract the sum of everything up to, but excluding the start point. Do the subtraction, and that's your answer. The beauty of this setup is that regardless of how large your input array gets, you're guaranteed to be able to fulfill each request using a constant number of steps. 2. In other words, the summation of values part no longer grows with n, and per the big O notation, that's a very good thing. Let's analyze. If you have m lookup operations, each taking constant time, under the big O notation, that is om times o1, or simply om. We've reduced this to linear time. Of course, we mustn't forget that we took some time to build our cumulative sums list. That doesn't come for free. In fact, if you have n items, it takes n steps to build your list, so that's O n work. But here's the thing, the final time complexity is an n times m. You only get that when you're repeatedly doing an expensive operation again and again. Not here, you only build your cumulative array once, before you do any querying. In other words, the time complexity here is O n, plus m. You do n steps first to build the cumulative list, then m steps to query it. These two operations are now independent of each other. Running the same test of 10,000 items and 10,000 queries, you'll notice that this improved algorithm completes almost instantly, over 150 times faster. We can even step up this idea into the realm of two or more dimensions. Let's say we now have a two-dimensional grid of numbers, and once again, we want to add up all the numbers within a subgrid that's rectangular in shape. You'll find such applications in computer graphics, say when you're trying to sample the average color out of a group of pixels when scaling down. Because this is now in 2D, you'll find you have to do one extra set of steps for many of the parts. For example, building the grid. This process is largely the same, except you'll have to deal with things dimension by dimension. For each row, first calculate the cumulative sums like you would with a regular flat array. Then, add this row into your cumulative grid by summing each item in the row with the value right above it. When set up this way, each cell in the cumulative grid gives us the sum of all values in a rectangle, from the upper left corner to the indicated cell. This particular order of operations must be followed so you don't double count or miss out on any cells. To get a sum from any rectangular subgrid, take the sum from the lower right corner. From it, subtract the sum from above the upper right corner. This takes out all the values above the subgrid of interest. Then, subtract the sum to the left of the bottom left corner. This takes out all the values to the left of the subgrid. Problem is, you have double subtracted that little space above and to the left of the upper left corner of your subgrid. No problem, right? We know exactly how far we are off. Look for the value one position left and above the upper left corner and add that value back into the sum. And we have an answer. This is a surprisingly simple way of making a potentially very expensive operation much cheaper. This is a 2D grid now, so things are a lot worse if you do things the naive way. By taking some time and memory up front to build a more convenient data structure for querying, you end up with great savings down the line, amplified by the fact that you're going to do many queries, each of which benefiting from this optimization. This is one of those cool tricks you can use in a world of computer science to make things more efficient, that might not be immediately obvious. That's all there is for today's episode. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, you're watching 0612 TV with NERDfirst.net.
Hey, have I been helpful? Want to see this channel grow? A PayPal donation or a super thanks would be incredible. Of course, you can always share the video, comment on it, like it, and subscribe. You know the deal. Thank you once again, and I'll see you next time.